Josh, Charles, fans have been waiting for 2 years for Will and Alicia to finally get together. And in the finale, it looks like they finally do. And now they have to wait 4 months. I mean, that's cruelty, right?
It is, but it's good because it lets everybody's imagination just take over and they can ponder what will happen starting in season three.
I mean, you even must be wanting to know what is going to happen next, right? I mean, are there any questions in your mind, or do you already know how it's all going to work out?
Well, I don't know how it's all going to work out. I mean, I think they're starting to maybe write the beginning of the season now. But I do, you know, in talking to Robert and Michelle King, there's a constant dialogue with them throughout the season. And so at the end of each year, we sort of go over where the arcs have come, what things have shifted, and what we're looking at as we go into next season. So I have an idea of the broad strokes of what they want to do. I don't necessarily know specifically how they're going to implement everything, but I do have a sense of it, and I'm very excited about it. I mean, obviously I can't talk too much about the future. Like I like to keep some of the fans. I think it's better to be surprised by it. But I am excited to, you know, one thing I can say is that, you know, we'll start to get more into Will's backstory in the beginning of season three at some point. It'll be a nice long arc where I think it'll be really revealing for the character, and I'm looking forward to playing that.
When you get a script like you had in the finale, and you shoot it, and everything's in the can, and you know it's weeks before it airs on TV, I mean, what's that period like when you know how the explosions are going to hit all across the country, and people are going to be talking about it, and you know all of what's going to happen, but you can't say anything?
Yeah, I mean, that was a tough part of doing some of the interviews for the finale, was to be able to, you know, do an interview with your hands tied behind your back. So now it's been nice to be able to at least talk about it now that it's out in the open and people have seen it and not have to worry about spoilers. But it was very exciting. I have to say, I mean, a real credit to our writers and our creators, as I said, Robert and Michelle King, is that these last three or four episodes of the season, I know I speak for a lot of the actors on the show, we all felt they each could have been season-ending episodes. They had that great reveal moment, and we just kept wondering how they were going to top it. So when I read the last one, I was thrilled to death because I thought, you know, it really handled the Will and Alicia situation, I thought, really well. You know, it was entertaining. It gave people what they wanted, but I thought it did it in a way that was you know, as you said earlier about, you know, having to wait 4 months, I thought it was a very clever way to entertain people and to sort of, you know, put it out there without maybe showing too much.
Well, we're an awards website, Josh. We cover the Emmys and the Oscars and all those kinds of things. And The Good Wife has been a huge hit and did very well last year. Archie won an Emmy and it was nominated for Best Series. And we're expecting it to do even better this time. And what was that like, though, being on the set of a show that's so popular and also so critically acclaimed?
It's great. I mean, I think we're all really proud of the show. I think doing a network show, I mean, you know, it has its complications, and the schedule is definitely not for sissies. You know, it's a tough schedule, and a lot of times we're envious of our friends on our cable programs by the length of their schedule. But with that said, it's a show that I think takes risks for a network show, risks with story, risks with character, and really allows things to arc and develop slowly, and believes in ambiguity and nuance. And so I think that, to me, it all starts with the writing. I mean, television is a writer's medium, and you know, we're just really blessed in this show. I mean, to get to shoot it in New York, which is my hometown, Juliana lives there, Christine, you know, it makes it even that much better. But it's a show we're really proud of, and I know Juliana said this before, and I just echo it, which is, we feel like we've got our cable show, it's just on a network, you know? And that's really how we feel. We're proud, you know, when we get nominated for the SAG Awards or for the Emmys, that, I believe for the SAG Awards, we were the last two years, the only network show that was nominated. And I think we all feel a lot of pride about that, and that starts with the writing, and obviously we have an incredible group of actors on the show as well. Mm-hmm.
Well, you're being submitted in the drama supporting actor category, and I know you don't know all the mechanisms of how it all works necessarily, but that particular category is just being wiped clean. The Lost guys are gone, Aaron Paul is gone, Martin Short is gone. They were all nominated last year, so there will definitely be some new nominees in that category. If you get nominated for The Good Wife, is there a particular highlight episode that you have this season that might be your submission?
You know, I don't really know. I mean, if I was fortunate enough to get included in that mix and get nominated, I'm sure I would look at that. And I would probably ask people, you know, I really take a lot of stock in you know, my fellow actors and friends' opinions a lot. You know, I would ask people that work with me. I mean, I sometimes they're a better gauge than I am. I mean, I do say there are certain moments throughout the season, and there's a scene here or there. Sometimes it's hard to maybe pinpoint a particular episode. And frankly, my memory is so bad that I'd have to go back and look at all of them because sometimes I have a hard time remembering what I did last week. But there's a lot of different stuff this year that I think the character really, you know, surprised me in some ways and in good ways and took some leaps. And so there's work in there that I feel good about, feel proud of. But I don't really know which one specifically yet, to be honest, if that should happen.
Yeah, I mean, look, just for our viewers who will all be thinking about this now, this is, there's a lot of people out there who actually really care about this stuff, Josh, and for you, you've got like at least three really amazing episodes. You've got the military court one, that was really impressive. You've got the one where Will's judge friend is possibly biased against him, that was towards the middle of the season. And then obviously you've got the finale that everyone is still talking about. You know, that, especially those last few scenes were so beautifully directed by Robert King, and you and Juliana really stepped it up there. So you've got three off the bat for you to pick from, apart from whatever else your friends and colleagues might tell you.
If I'm lucky enough to get nominated, then I'm gonna get on this thing here, this Ubu thing, and I'm gonna get you guys back in here and ask you.
Awesome. That's we've helped a lot of over the years.
When you mention those episodes, though, I mean, the one thing that jumps out, in because it's that you pick those, is, you know, Dean Parasot directed Double Jeopardy, Tom DiCillo directed the Two Courts, and as you said, Robert beautifully directed the finale, and I must say that again, the guy keeps amazing me with his talent. I thought it was such a tight episode, beautifully shot, tried some new things in it that we hadn't done. I mean, he's just such a visual thinker, gave really astute and clear direction. And also, you know, I think it's his and Michelle's creation, and he's had the benefit of watching these last two seasons, different directors come in and see what he likes, see what he doesn't like, see what he wants to try. He's the one sort of putting the final touches on all the editing. And I think that paid huge dividends for him as a director, and I hope he does more and more. But the three that you mentioned, I think a lot of those, while Robert is a writer and created the show, all three of those people, particularly, you know, with Dean and I know with Tom, are really interested in behavior, you know? And a lot of times in television, that it is a writer's medium, and Robert's not like this, which is kind of amazing. I mean, he wants the behavior as well, but so much attention is put in TV on words, you know, being that it is this writer's medium, that we focus solely on the words, and that those two directors and Robert as well really pushed the behavior as much as possible, and what's landing, what's happening, what's going on subtextually, what's happening underneath the words. And that's just interesting that you picked those episodes because, I think that there must be something to that, you know, and I know for me it was really challenging to work on all three of those episodes. And there are also episodes where you get to see, you know, the moral ambiguity of Will, and also his sort of tenaciousness in the courtroom, you know, and sort of see that balanced. I think he's a character that really wants to win at all costs and is not interested in the morality of things and doesn't care if people like him or not. He's not doing things for the, quote, right reason. He's doing it because he wants to win, either for his law firm or for his clients. And I think, you know, what I think is nice is you see personally, you see little glimpses of what that's done, those choices that he's made to do that in his career, how that's affected his personal life. And I think we'll continue to see more of that in the third season. And I think it'll be, you know, for me as an actor, I want to see him. I want to see the repercussions for the choices that he's made, that he's decided to make for his career.
Well, I wanted to, you're on a basically an all-star team here on The Good Wife, an incredible cast, but you've done that your whole career. It's kind of amazing that just about every all-star team out there, whether it's Sports Night or In Treatment or Dead Poets Society or when you've been on stage or so forth, you're just always surrounded by all these other great actors. When you're out in public, you meet a fan, you meet somebody, other than The Good Wife, since it's current, what project do people most bring up with you?
You know, it varies from time to time. I mean, certainly there was a period in New York. King's Treatment has a really loyal following. You know, I think that show really got under people's skins in a way that when I first watched the Israeli version, it did for me. Certainly people, Sportsnet has a cult following as well, and then different films that I've done throughout the years. It's random day to day, but it's always nice. I find most people to be really friendly, and it always feels good when people want to talk to you and let you know that your work has made them happy. I mean, that's a good feeling, or that your work has touched them in some way. We do this so that we can connect with audiences. You know, we can through our characters can show some humanity, and if that humanity makes someone laugh or touch someone, years later, that's a nice feeling. So,
well, Josh, thank you so much for your time today. We really do appreciate it, and we wish you all the best for the Emmys coming up and for season 3, which is now going to be airing on Sunday. So it's going to be CBS prestige show, and I guess it's all the better for you, I guess. You know, more exposure and hopefully some Emmys.
Absolutely. Well, we'll see, man. You know, all that stuff's out of my control, but we're just having such a great time doing the show. And like I said, I think we're all really proud of it. I love everyone I work with, and that means a lot, because as you know, you interview all of us. I mean, doing these shows, I see people in the good way during the season more than I see my girlfriend or members of my family. And so who you work with means a great deal. It really does. And we have such a fine group on this show. And I'm not just saying actors, just great human beings, really cool people. And it all starts with Jules. I mean, she's just phenomenal. And, just love her. Couldn't ask for a better leading lady. Okay, guys, thanks a lot.
Thanks.
Thank you.